Hello and welcome to this video on error detection using cyclic redundancy code check. Myself, Mr. Vipul Kondekar from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. At the end of this session, students will be able to differentiate between the two error control schemes, error detection and error correction. Student will be able to calculate the CRC code for the given data using generator polynomial and identify the presence of error, whether in the data, transmitted data, if error is there or not, can be identified with the help of CRC. These are the contents of this video presentation. We will talk about error control technique, error detection correction, CRC code, what is generator polynomial, division, how we carry out at the time of encoding, and how decoding is done to identify the error in the transmission. When you are talking about the error control, basically when you are transmitting the data is going over channel. Channel itself is sometimes unreliable. So when you want to make your communication reliable, over unreliable channel, you need to have some sort of error control techniques. Now this error control can be done in two different ways. Either you can go for error correction techniques. This is also called as forward error correction or forward error control. You transmit the data. If error is detected, then try to correct the error at the receiver side itself. So this technique is called as error correction, where you detect the error as well as correct the error. And then another approach, which is also called as reverse error control, is error detection technique. Here only error is detected, and once the error is detected, then receiver will ask for retransmission of the data to the sender. So retransmission will take place. You are using error correction or detection. Ultimately, what you do for that is, suppose n number of bits you are sending as a code word, so that n bits will be made up of actual m number of message bits. To that, r bits, r redundant bits, are getting added. So actual code word sent will have message bits along with some redundant bits, and then these redundant bits will give you ability of detecting the error or correcting the error. Now think when to use error correction technique and when to use error detection technique. Now we'll go for CRC, cyclic redundancy check technique, for error detection. So here only error is detected. D number of data bits, suppose you want to send. So what we do is we take the help of G as a generator polynomial. So that generator polynomial has, let us say, R plus one number of bits. Then what we do is we use that R bits in such a that we concatenate the data bits along with the CRC code, which is generated by using a modulo 2 division technique. Now this modulo 2 division is when you are doing in mod 2 operation, your addition and subtraction is analogous to XOR operation itself. In the example, we will see how this mod 2 division is carried out. So you will use generator polynomial, and then data will get divided by that generator polynomial. Now receiver knows that generator polynomial. So what receiver does? Receiver again divides that transmitted code, which is generated, by the same generator polynomial. And if the remainder is non-zero, then error is detected. And if remainder is zero, then there is no error in the transmission. This is what conclusion you can make. This CRC is quite popular technique. It is widely used in the practice for Ethernet or 802.11 Wi-Fi ATM as well. Now let us try to understand this CRC check. how it is carried out. If you have some data D, so to that data, I already at the transmitter side, I append n number of bits. Now, how many bits you will append? It depends on if your divisor, which will be decided by the generator polynomial, has n plus 1 number of bits, this number of zeros will be n. Means if your divisor has 5 bits, here 4 bits you will append. Now, data along with these appended zeros, this whole thing is divided by the divisor, and this divisor will be decided by the generator polynomial. And whatever is the remainder of that, that remainder is called as CRC code, and that CRC code will be of n bits. Now, what I can do is these n bits can be appended here. So, data previously all zeros were there, but while sending, what I do is data, and instead of zeros, these CRC bits will be appended here. And at the receiver side, what I do, whatever is the received data, I will use the same divisor. Very important thing is this divisor and this divisor has to be same. And then I will check for the remainder. And if remainder is zero, then it means that there is no error in the transmission. And if remainder is non-zero, means the error has occurred in the transmission. So that data has to be rejected. And then this receiver will ask for retransmission to the sender. Now, let us try to understand different generator polynomials available. These are few standard generator polynomial examples. So, let us take, this is one generator polynomial, x raised to 7, x raised to 5. So, then from this generator polynomial, I can form a divisor. And the divisor will be what? Wherever that x raised to 7 means 7 degree is available. So, there I write 1. So, x raised to 0 is 1, fine. So, x raised to 1 is present, I write 1. X raised to 3 and x raised to 4 are not present in this polynomial. So, at these locations, I write 0, 0. As well, x raised to 6 is not available here, I write 0. So, based on this generator polynomial, I can have binary equivalent of the divisor. Now, what I do is, these are some standard generator polynomials used if you are using asynchronous transmission ATM. So, CRC 8 is used. As well as this CRC 16 is used for HDLC, High Data Link Layer Control Protocol. As well, same thing is used for Bluetooth also. And for LANs, Ethernet, this CRC 32 is the generator polynomial used for the error control. Now, let us try to understand how error is detected using CRC. Now, assume that this is the data you want to send. So, data has 4 bits. Now, I decide that the generator polynomial, based on generator polynomial, this is the divisor what I have. So, divisor has 4 bits. So, what I do is, I append 3 zeros here. Then, I carry out mod 2 division. So, when you are carrying out mod 2 division, you look at the most significant bit appearing here. And if that bit is 1, I write quotient as 1. And then, if quotient is 1, this whole divisor I will be writing here. So, this is 1011. Now, actually, in regular division, you are carrying out here subtraction. But if it is mod 2 division, this subtraction is analogous to the XORing operation. So, this 1 XOR 1 will be 0. So, like this, I do that XORing operation, I get here 010. And then, as here I have 4 bits, I take 1 bit from here. This is the appended, 3 appended zeros are there. So, now look at this. Here again, most significant bit is 0. So, the quotient part I write it as 0, and then if leftmost bit is 0, use 000 as a divisor. So again I write 000 here. Now again I do mod operation. Here most significant bit is 1, so I write here 1, and then I write divisor as it is. I do mod 2 subtraction, I get this result. Finally I get this remainder. Remainder is 110. So now what I do is how I form code word. Is code word is formed by actual data bits appended with the remainder what you got here. So, this will be the data word which you will be sending. Now, assume that this data word is sent. Let us have two cases where the data word is sent which has no error, and this is the same data word sent, but what you find here is this bit is altered. This bit is becoming 0. Actually, it was 1. So, now what happens? Again, what I do is I use the same generator polynomial for the receiver side. Again, I carry out mod 2 division. And then what I get, I check for the remainder here. Now, if I find that reminder is 000, it means that there is no error in the transmitted data. But here, if I look at this division, here I know that this error has occurred. But how? The system will come to know error has occurred. So system will carry out again mod to division at the side of receiver for decoding purpose. And then when that division is carried out, what result you get is non-zero. And when the result is non-zero, you can conclude that the data word has got error. So that has to be discarded and the receiver will ask for retransmission of the data to the sender. So this is how CRC will be doing the error detection. That error control will be of forward error control, where that will be of reverse error control, where the receiver will detect the error, and once the error is detected, receiver will ask for retransmission of the data, and then it will be expected, it is expected that when you are transmitting when you are retransmitting the data, there will not be any error. So basically, when you go for error detection technique, you assume that the channel is reliable. And because of some reason, if error has occurred, then when the data is retransmitted, the probability of occurrence of the error in the retransmitted data is very less. In that case, we go for using error detection techniques. So this is how the CRC code can be used for error control. It can detect the occurrence of the error. So these are the references used for this video presentation. Thank you.